In today's session, we are going to get introduction about IEEE 555 timer. At the end of this today's session, students will be able to describe the features, pin diagram, and internal functional block diagram of IEEE 555 timer. These are the contents of my today's presentation. You have already studied a flip-flop and the different types of flip-flops. Please recall, what is the SR flip-flop? SR flip-flop is one of the internal functional block of IEEE 555 timer. SR flip-flop is set reset flip-flop. It has two inputs and two outputs. The two inputs are set and reset, and the two outputs are Q and Q bar. The two outputs are complement of each other. When set input is high and reset input is low, flip-flop sets, its Q output becomes high and Q bar output becomes low. High output equals high voltage level and low output equals low voltage level. So when reset input is high and set input is low, flip-flop resets. Its Q bar output becomes high and Q output becomes low. So Q bar output equals high voltage level. So flip-flop remains in one of these stable state, either in set state or in reset state. Using S input, that is set input, we can set the flip-flop, make Q output high and Q bar low. And using R input, that is a reset input, we can reset the flip-flop. Its Q bar output becomes high and Q output becomes low. The IEEE 555 timer is most versatile general purpose linear integrated circuit, named as IEEE 555 or NE 555 from manufacturing company Signetic Corporation. It is highly reliable, easy to use, and cheaper in cost. It is a timing circuit that can generate very accurate and highly stable time delays or oscillations. IEEE 555 timer has a variety of applications like monostable multivibrator, a stable multivibrator, waveform generator, digital logic probe, etc. Now let us see the features of IEEE 555 timer. IEEE 555 timer operates on wide range of DC power supply voltages from plus 5 volt to plus 18 volt DC. It operates on wide range of temperature. The temperature range for IEEE 555 is minus 55 degrees centigrade to 125 degrees centigrade. For IEEE 555 timer, NE 555, the operating temperature range is from 0 to 70 degrees centigrade. The output voltage level of IEEE 555 is compatible with TTL logic circuit voltage levels as well as CMOS logic circuit voltage levels. The output signal voltage level of IEEE 555 timer is equals with a TTL voltage level as well as CMOS voltage level. The output of IEEE 555 can source or sink current up to 200 milliampere. IEEE 555 timer generates a timing from nanoseconds to hours. Basically, IEEE 555 timer can be operated in two modes, a stable mode or monostable mode. These are the two basic operating modes of IEEE 555 timer. Now this was a pin configuration of IEEE 555 timer. Physically, IEEE 555 is available in two packages, DIP package and metal can package. It is a 8-pin IC. Pin number 1 is a ground pin, and pin number 2 is the trigger input of IEEE 555. Pin number 3 is the pin that is output of IEEE 555, and pin number 4 is a reset input for IEEE 555. Pin number 5 is a control voltage input for 555, and pin number 6 is named as a threshold. It is an input for timer IC. Pin number 7 is named as a discharge, and pin number 8 is a plus VCC. Now this shows internal functional block diagram of IC555 timer. Internally, IC555 timer consists of a voltage divider which consists of two equal resistors. It is acting as a resistor network, and it consists of two voltage level comparators, comparator 1 and comparator 2, and a single SR flip-flop, and the two transistors, transistor Q1 is a discharge transistor and transistor Q2 is a reset transistor. The resistor network, which consists of three equal resistors, acts as a voltage divider. It is used to generate threshold voltage or a reference voltage for a comparator. It generates a reference voltage of 2/3 VCC. It is applied to inverting input of upper comparator, comparator 1. And it generates a 1/3 VCC. It is applied as a reference voltage for non-inverting input of lower comparator, comparator 2. The voltage level comparator compares voltage applied at threshold input with the voltage applied to inverting input, and comparator 2 compares voltage applied at a trigger input, pin number 2, with the reference voltage of 1/3 VCC from internal voltage divider. The output of two comparators are given to set and reset input of a flip-flop. When the voltage at non-inverting input is higher than the voltage at inverting input, output of a comparator becomes high. So that is given to set or reset input of a flip-flop. When set input is high and reset input is low, flip-flop sets. So its Q output becomes high and Q bar output becomes low. When output of comparator 2 is high, it resets a flip-flop, and so that Q bar output of a flip-flop is high and Q output is low. Transistor Q1 and Q2 are used to Q1 is used to discharge external capacitor, and Q2 is used to reset a timer IC. Now let us discuss the pin configuration of IC555 timer. Pin description: pin number 1 is a ground terminal. All voltages are applied and measured with respect to this terminal. Pin number 2 is named as a trigger terminal. This pin is nothing but inverting input of internal comparator 2 that causes a transition of internal flip-flop from set to reset. Internally, this pin is connected with the inverting input of a lower comparator. The comparator compares voltage at this pin with 1/3 VCC. So whenever the voltage at pin number 2 becomes just less than 1/3 VCC, the output of lower comparator, that is comparator 2, becomes high, and that resets internal flip-flop, so that the output of timer becomes high. The output of timer depends on voltage level of trigger pulse applied to this pin. When voltage at pin number 2 just falls below 1/3 VCC, the flip-flop resets, and its Q output becomes high, and Q bar output becomes low. Pin number 3 is named as output terminal. The output signal of timer is available at this pin with two possible voltage levels, either high voltage level or low voltage level. The output load can be connected either between pin number 3 and ground, pin number 1. And the load is known as normally off load, or it can be connected between pin number 3 and power supply pin number 8, known as normally on load. The output has two possible voltage levels, either a high voltage level or a low voltage level. Pin number 4 is a reset terminal. To disable or reset timer at low voltage level, a negative pulse is applied to this pin. That's why it is known as a reset terminal. When it is not used, it is connected to plus VCC to avoid a false triggering. Pin number 5 is named as a control voltage terminal. This pin is internally connected to inverting input of comparator 1. This pin is used to control or change threshold and trigger levels by connecting external potentiometer in between VCC and ground, and its variable terminal is connected to pin number 5. When this pin is not used, connected to ground pin 1 through 0.01 microfarad capacitor to avoid any noise problem. Pin number 6 is a threshold terminal. This pin is connected with non-inverting input of internal comparator 1. The comparator compares the voltage applied to this pin with the threshold voltage, that is the reference voltage of 2/3 VCC obtained from internal voltage divider. If voltage at this pin is just above 2/3 VCC, then flip-flop sets and output of timer is at low level. Pin number 7 is named as a discharge terminal. This pin is internally connected to collector of N-pin transistor. Mostly, external capacitor is connected between this pin and ground. When transistor turns on, capacitor discharges through transistor. Hence, this pin is named as, and this transistor is named as discharge transistor. When transistor is off, the capacitor charges at the rate decided by the time constant of external capacitor and resistor. Pin number 8 is a supply terminal. A DC power supply voltage of plus 5 volts to plus 18 volts can be applied to this terminal with respect to a ground pin for the working of IC555 timer. This is the reference. Thank you.